Do you have a butt kicker or transducer that's not getting the job done? Is it shaking to just the low-end sounds? What if it shook when it was supposed to? SimVibe is an advanced multi-dimensional audio-based feedback software that utilizes 1 to 8 bass transducers and provides the correct physics-based vibrations throughout your simulator. This can greatly enhance immersion and drivability. All you need is one shaker, an extra sound card, and SimVibe software. Check it out for yourself. Go to simexperience.com and then click on products and then SimVibe. Welcome to Inside Sim Racing. I'm Darren Ganji and I'm here with my review of the JCL Sim Racing 2B Faster Sim Racing chassis. The 2B Faster, which I'm going to call the TBF, was designed by two French sim racers, JC Goddard and Ludovic Lassave. JC and Ludovic are avid iRacers and part of the team JCL Sim Racing. They came up with the design when JC ordered a cockpit with triple monitor support and was disappointed with the quality and lack of a realistic driving position. After 2 years of research, he finally found aluminum T-slotted extrusion profiles, fasteners, brackets, and had parts specifically machined for the TBF. The TBF is shipped unassembled and nicely packaged, and it can also be assembled and ready to race, but I believe that is for local sim racers if you're in France and close to their facility. It's available in 2 colors, black and what I have in the aluminum, and is made of anodized aluminum profile with 80 by 40 and 40 by 40 millimeter sections. The cockpit also comes with cable routes and pieces that fit into the slots of the profiles. The profile is assembled using 8 millimeter screws and 6 millimeter hollow heads and are connected using these particular nuts. They are equipped with a spring-loaded ball that prevent them from slipping under their own weight and can be directly inserted into the slots. These help aid in the assembly, and I'd have to say these are the best I have ever used for profile. Now, if you're not familiar with T-slot aluminum like this, it basically allows you to configure it any way you want as long as you have the pieces cut to the right lengths and the brackets to put them together in a proper configuration. I've been asked many times about the old rig that I used to have that was using aluminum T-slot and the dimensions for it, but honestly, it was just a bunch of random parts put together from leftover T-slot that we had acquired from Chris Considine at CXC, and it worked great, but it really wasn't a design that was worthy of measuring and transitioning to somebody else for use. So getting back to the TBF, this is specifically designed as a sim racing chassis, and you can tell that the guys at JCL Sim Racing put a lot of time and effort into getting it right. Besides the cockpit, JCL also offers individual pieces of the T-slot profile for sale. You can get them from 100 millimeter length up to 1200 millimeters. And it's going to vary based on the length. The cost is going to vary based on the length. So if you want to add your own pieces, you know, say you have a button box or something like that, you can order the pieces individually. Needless to say, I'm being in America and they're in France. Mine came unassembled in pieces, very nicely packaged with instructions that they have upgraded since. My instructions lacked a little bit of detail and I offered them that feedback based on my assembly, and they have since added more detail to the instructions, so it is a lot easier to assemble now, I'm assuming. Pricing on the chassis can vary depending on what options you get and where you are located. Right now they have a special where all items are marked down 10% through the end of June. The exchange rate of euros to US dollars is pretty close right now. So for example, the base chassis I have here goes for 436.50 euro, which equates to $475. And that's with the 10% discount. That doesn't include the wheel mount, and you need to add that as an option based on the type of wheel you own. The base chassis comes with the frame, mouse support, pedal bracket for Fanatec, Derek Spear Designs, and Husingveld pedals, with all the hardware to assemble everything, cable routing pieces, and end caps. The extra options I was sent include tilt support for Thrustmaster bases, triple screen mounts with separate legs. You can also get them where they attach directly to the wheel stand or wheel portion upright, and I opted. They originally sent them to me that way, but I asked to have them separate because in watching one of their videos of the chassis, I saw a little bit of wobble in those monitors and I wanted to eliminate that altogether. It's honestly hard to not have some kind of wobble at the deck no matter what a rig is built at, just because of the side-to-side forces that you're getting inherently out of a force feedback or any kind of wheel. Also came with a keyboard support tray, which I opted not to use. I'll talk about that in a second. Audio 5.1 support, gearbox support, and all that comes to $1,031.06. Shipping is $342.61 to my location for a grand total of $1,373.67. So I mentioned I didn't use the keyboard tray. It's because I had this one from a GamePod chassis that I had, and it fit perfectly in the spot that I wanted to. There's attached to the monitor supports, and I just didn't want it located there. And I like my keyboard tray. And that's honestly the beauty of using T-slot aluminum profile, is that you can add things to it pretty much wherever, as long as you have the hardware. I also added a wheel deck plate from an old rig I had to add some stability to their attachments. Since I run a Thrustmaster base, the pieces they sent have a little bit of deck wobble, or basically the wheel tilts just a little bit on you. And by adding that plate, it pretty much eliminates all wobble and just kind of creates a better platform for the Thrustmaster wheelbase. Mine came without a seat, and you can order it with a seat. They have some pretty nice seats available. I believe OMP or Sparco, something like that, for fairly affordable pricing. And you can also purchase a full turnkey solution package with a PC. I think it comes with a T500 wheel and pedal set. They have a bunch of different options at their website. They had just converted their site over to English and for US dollars, and I did find some bugs here and there, which they are correcting. I've given them some feedback on that as well. You might find some things in French, and if you do, just go into Google Translator and translate it over if you get a little bit lost. So since I mounted mine to this base, it took about 8 hours for the main cockpit to assemble, plus the accessories, and then another 2 to 3 hours for the triple monitor stand once I got that all set up. I've been using the TBF now for about 4 months, and I originally had a GT Omega triple monitor stand as I waited for the extra leg supports that they sent for this particular monitor stand. I've raced in the 24 hours of Daytona, the 12 hours of Sebring, the Daytona 500, even though I only lasted about 5 laps in that race. I got through about half of the Indy 500 last weekend, a handful of other races on iRacing, so I have done quite a bit of racing in this chassis. I figured out a way to mount my butt kicker under the pedals and in the back of my seat. I have my button box mounted with extra pieces I had from that previous rig I mentioned with T-slot, so I have some extra T-slot pieces that I've mounted. And again, that's the beauty of having a rig like this, is that as long as you have the hardware, you can mount anything to it. They also sent me this cool mount for my Sim Instruments dash that I've been able to utilize. Now I'm gonna head to some pros and cons and then wrap things up. First, the pros. This thing is solid as a rock, both at the wheel deck and pedal deck, and has very little wobble, even with the monitor stands bolted to the chassis. It's infinitely configurable, so you can add to it and or reconfigure it to fit you. Very adjustable. Ergonomically correct, whereas the wheel, pedal, and seat arrangement are all properly placed. And again, with the infinite adjustability, you can fit it to how you want it. It's got support for all the major wheel and pedal sets and even some other wheel and pedal sets. Like I mentioned, Husingveld, Derek Spear Designs. You can get an AccuForce wheel mount. They've really added accessories to make it so anybody can really use this rig. And actually, they could probably even design something or figure out something for you if you have something that isn't on their list of accessories. It looks cool. I bet it looks even cooler in black. Black is a little bit more expensive too, by the way. The hardware is easy to work with and allows you to reconfigure things due to that spring-loaded nut I had mentioned. Now I'm gonna get to the cons, and there's very few actually, and one really only relates to the chassis, and that's I had to add that wheel deck piece to add some stability, or the plate I should say, for my Thrustmaster base. I have a feeling with some of the other bases on the market, like a Fanatic, or a Logitech, or maybe even the AccuForce, it provides more mounting spots. The next con, it can be expensive, depending on how many options you add, but you get what you pay for, so I really wouldn't consider it a con. I honestly think it's worth that price. And then shipping can be expensive all the way here to the US, so again, you're adding about $300, almost $400 for shipping to get it here, so that's the last con. Now onto my final thoughts. And as I mentioned, there weren't many cons except for that one about the wheel deck. And I have to say that this setup is probably one of my favorite chassis and triple monitor stand combos that I've ever tried. I love the configurability. I love how solid it is. I love the way it looks. It fit on my base barely. I mean, it just barely fit. I had to do some drilling on my base, which is why it took me some extra time to assemble. Most of the chassis you buy are manufactured a certain way and may not work for someone that's tall or short. Some may have some wobble, some may not be adjustable. The 2B Faster does it all and can be tailored to fit you. It was developed by sim racers and it really shows. Sure, it uses aluminum extrusion tubing that anyone can purchase, but these guys have designed it to be stable and versatile and have also fabricated parts specifically for a sim racing application. I rarely switch out my main PC racing chassis due to the complexity of it, and that should tell you how much I like the 2B Faster. You're most likely going to see this as my main sim racing chassis for a long time to come. I'd like to thank JC and Ludwig for sending this to me and being patient for me to get this review up. Like I said, I've been running this thing for about 4 months. I was honestly waiting for their website to get finished in English because it was originally all in French. Actually, originally they didn't even have a website. They were selling through eBay when they first sent me the chassis. So I was giving them some time. I wanted to spend some time with it, get the triple monitor stand, all that. And I'm glad I did. And I'm glad they were patient enough to wait for me on it. So I hope you've enjoyed this review of the 2B Faster by JCL Sim Racing. Come to our website to see one of the most extensive or the most extensive list of sim racing chassis reviews in the world. And you can visit us at isrtv.com. I'm Darren Ganger for Inside Sim Racing. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys next time.